Two of you dating? How long have you guys been dating?
3 months.
3 months. Oh, this is new. That's nice.
This is a relationship with the plastic cover still there, no? The plastic is still there. Nikala nahi abhi plastic. Abhi tak hai.
That's nice. What's your name, man?
Vrinda.
Vrinda. Vrinda and?
Elliot.
Elliot, where are you from?
US.
The US. Okay. Who did you vote for? Did you vote in this election?
Yeah.
Who did you vote for?
Biden.
All right. We like you. And then you came to a country where Modi is in power. Elliot, is it okay if we as Indians are invested in the presidential election of your country? It is, right? It's fair. I think it's fair because of the impact that a US president has on world politics. And also that this is the closest we will come to watching a vile, divisive bigot getting voted out of office. Where will we get to experience this? Oh, whatever. And where did you meet Vrinda?
On a dating app.
Oh, right. Nice. Which one?
Hinge.
Hinge. Hinge is the one where you can trust the person you're about to meet. Tinder's full like shooting in the dark. You don't know what's going to be there on the other side. If it's a man, woman, child, or an ogre, you don't know what's there on the other side. Hinge is still slightly reliable. That's true, right, Vrinda?
Yeah.
Hinge is a little reliable because you only meet people who are friends of friends.
It's not like that.
It's not like that anymore?
It used to be like that.
It used to be like that. But people were not meeting the right people. They're like, fuck it, kisi ko bhi leke aa. Your business model is bullshit. The people I know terrible people. I don't know why these people are friends with these people, but I met this person and he's a fucking piece of shit. Just release the hounds, send everyone. That's what I thought it was. Hinge was a little more reliable because you thought you were meeting a friend of a friend, right? So I've not been on Hinge. So what happened? You get a match. You match and then you start chatting straight away?
Yeah, so you can comment on the other person's
post. Oh yeah. You can comment on their page.
Their status and say, okay, yeah, that's fine.
Right. You guys on Hinge? So, Tinder is straight up.
Yeah.
I want to fuck, I don't want to fuck. Left, right. Meet me in the gully. It's very, it's just, there's no middle ground there. With Hinge, I remember I was on Hinge very briefly. You have to like create a profile and you have to upload about 2 or 3 pictures, and then they'll ask you some questions like a slam book from the 90s, no? Your favorite actor and the motto you live by. You have to say some fancy shit, and then you make like a small mini presentation of this is who I am, please fuck me. And that's what happens. And then if people match and they like you, you can hit like on the stuff that they've posted or they've said, and then you can start chatting. Right? This is a separate chat window. So is that how it started with you guys as well? You hit like on something? Did you see something of his that you liked? And do you remember what you clicked on? Because this is important for you to remember these facts, because one day your kids are going to ask you, like, you know, hey, mom, dad, what did you like about daddy? And you got to go, like, you can't say, like, you know, green card, you know? You have to... You have to be a little subtle. Yeah. So what is it? Do you remember what it is? The first thing that caught your attention about Elliot?
Don't really be putting me on the spot. I don't have an answer. But I just want to know what like a white person is doing in India.
You want to know what a white person is doing in India, and then you ended up doing the white person.
That's cool. Do you feel she gives you enough compliments?
No.
Not enough.
See, I don't know, women, if you've dated a good-looking man, I don't know if you've ever done that, but don't think that we take this for granted, that we know it. You need to remind us of things we already know. Every other day is fine, Elliot? Hourly, at least. I think that's fair, right? Like, because, I know, like, hot women, now they've... What to tell you now? Where to start? Because they are like, oh, yeah, am I looking nice? Do I look good in this? And stuff like that, which you do. Then we also wore a shirt, no? I think the argument between the genders is that women take a lot of effort.
And they put in more effort than men to look good. Is that fair? So I sometimes feel that women think that because we put in little effort, we're not waiting for the compliment. But we are. Is that right, Elliot?
Absolutely.
Like, as anybody else in a relationship over here? Come on, guys, let's do this, man. Let's fight for our rights, buddy. Yeah. He's like, hey, Urja, wake up, wake up. He's waking up. What's your name, buddy?
Prajwal.
Prajwal and?
Prajwal
with the P. Prajwal and?
Vilma.
Vilma and Prajwal. Acha. Okay. And you guys have been together for a while?
10 years.
Oh, shit. God damn it. Compliments have dried up by a lot. Compliments are fossils in your relationship right now. Like, archaeologists can show up to your house and they start digging. And they're like, here's the compliment we found from 2009. It is buried deep inside the ground, as you can see. Vrinda, when was the last time you gave Elliot a compliment? You need some help?
I can't remember.
I love the way you make me feel, Elliot. You know, when I'm with you, it makes me forget of all the horrible shit I've been through and what it took for me to get to a place where I could share a life with somebody as amazing as you are.
That's
so many problems. Let's... Fuck, send her home. I don't even know him. Never met him on Hinge. But I said something that melted his heart. Tonight when you have sex with him, he'll be thinking about me now. Elliot, what's the thing you love about, one thing that you love about Vrinda the most?
She does really cute things for me.
She does really cute things for you. See, there you go. Okay, so I'll tell you what, okay, Vrinda, whenever, and everybody else, pay attention, okay, I'm going to teach you something. There you go. When you know your partner's fishing for a compliment, start with something vague. Like what Elliot just said. Say it again, Elliot.
She does really cute things.
That's nice. It's very positive, but vague. So when your partner hears this, they're like, "Oh," and then 3 seconds later, like, "But what cute?" So what happens when you start vague? You buy yourself time, because honestly, after you've been with a person long enough, you're not thinking about all the nice things or all the things that make you love them. You're thinking about all the things that you are tolerating enough to not leave them. Correct, Vilma? Yeah. So suddenly if you have to say something nice, you can't straight away just fish something out, no? Out of the well. So you have to start with something vague. Like, she does really cute things for me. And while your partner's then gushing and going, "Oh," you have to start thinking about one or two cute things that she has done, because she will ask you. She's already thinking it right now. Motherfucker, what cute things? I want to be also more specific, because women like specific compliments. Okay, men just like compliments. We don't expect too much. You say something nice, we will not even think if that is applicable to us or not. Like, "I love the way you scratched my back the other night. It was so good." Like, you've not scratched her back. You have not touched her back the other night. Somebody else has scratched her back, but you're feeling good about it. That's how low the bar is for men. Okay. You feel good about somebody else scratching a woman's back, like, "Yeah, I did that." Like, when? Like, you know? But women like their compliments to be specific. So if you say, "I like the cute things that she does," Vrinda, your first thing you thought was, "Name three." Right? You're thinking, "Okay, what cute things?" Because it has to be narrow and focused. Women are very focused in relationships. Do you speak a lot of Hindi?
A little bit.
A little bit?
I take Hindi tuition.
You take Hindi tuition? Oh, that's damn sweet. From who?
From a lady in Bandra.
From a lady in Bandra. Nice. Nice. I also want to take tuition. A lady in Bandra just sounds... Doesn't it sound exotic?
She's an old
Bori
lady.
I heard boring lady. She's an old Bori lady. Okay. But you voted for Biden, so that's okay. So just tell us some of the things you've learned in Hindi. Like how fluent are you? Know, level 1 to 10?
Intermediate.
So like 5? 3?
3 or 4.
3. So you can get by?
Yeah.
You can get by. So if you have to hail a rickshaw to get somewhere, what do you do?
Wave my hand.
And what do you say?
Rickshaw, ruko.
No, that's not right. I'm sorry, I don't know. Please ask for your money back. Elliot, if you ever want a rickshaw to stop for you, you can't go, hey, rickshaw, ruko. You have to go. Boss! Can you try? Can you make that sound? Do it again. Don't look at her. Look at me. I'm sorry. I was locked down for 9 months, guys. I honestly had no idea that I was going to do a show tonight where I was just going to a white guy and go. What have you learned profanity?
Yeah.
That's the lady from Bandra hasn't taught you
no,
that. She obviously. What has she taught you?
There's mother chow.
He says it with such eloquence. Hey, mother chow. Like if somebody calls me a mother chow like that, I'll take an order. Yes, sir. What would you like to eat? I know we're in a Croma store right now, but would you like me to get you some food? I don't know. You just said it so well. Madhur Chod. And then?
Aapki maa ki chod.
Dude, my mom's blushing now. She's just like, oh, stop it, Elliot. I swear, I'm taking Elliot's number after this. And if I were getting into a heated conversation with somebody and I have to diffuse the situation, I just call Elliot, put him on speaker. Elliot, go! Aapki maa ki chood. And that fucker will be like, Daddy? That's fucking clear. What's the most crude... Come on, Mirzapur fans. Come on, wake up. Okay, I'll teach you one line. I want to say, Bhosri wale chacha.
Bhosri wale chacha.
So now, when is the next family outing? The next wedding anniversary / some family gathering is going. Diwali just wrapped up. So next Diwali, you have an entire... When you guys get engaged, perfect. That's amazing, dude. Like, when you get engaged, you'll have to like, you'll have a party, obviously. So when they do get engaged, I'll be invited, fuckers. I will be there with my phone out, where Elliot will then go to walk up to one of the cha-chas. And I'll be there with the camera. Go, Elliot, go. And Elliot will like, hey, Bhosri wale chacha. Nacho na. Mother chur. All right, guys, that's my time. Thank you so much for coming for the show.